हेलो, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ जस्टिस एट बॉम्बे ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड 1668 टू 1726. सो लेट्स डिस्कस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ जस्टिस एट बॉम्बे. इंट्रोडक्शन. पोर्तुगीज वेयर द फर्स्ट यूरोपियंस टू एक्वायर द आइलैंड ऑफ बॉम्बे इन 1534 फ्रॉम द किंग ऑफ गुजरात. द पोर्तुगीज किंग Alphonsus VI transferred the island to Charles II as a dowry on the marriage of his sister Catherine. Crown Charles II transferred the island of Bombay to the East India Company through the charter of 1668, which he had got as a dowry from the Portuguese king in 1661 when he married Princess Catherine, the sister of the Portuguese king. The British crown transferred this island to East India Company in 1668 at annual rent of £10. Thus, the island of Bombay became a part of the British Empire in 1661. The administration of justice in Bombay developed in three stages, that is during the three period, and they are as follows. The first period is from 1668 to 1683. The second period is or stage is from 1684 to 1690. And the third stage or period is from 1718 to 1726. The charter of 1668 empowered the company to make, establish and enact laws, ordinances and constitutions for the good government of the island of Bombay. The charter also authorized the company to establish court of judicature, which was similar to those established in England. Administration of justice at Bombay during the first period, that is from 1668 to 1683. So let's discuss the first period. Judicial reforms of 1670 or judicial plan of 1670. The first judicial system was introduced in 1670. Gerald Ongier, he was the governor of Bombay, he introduced or reorganized old judicial setup of Bombay. He introduced or reorganized certain reforms in the old setup of the judicial machinery at Bombay because it was ruled by Portuguese. According to the reforms of 1670, the island of Bombay was divided into two divisions. And in each division, a court, that is court of judicature, was started in each division. One division consisted of Bombay, Mazgaon and Girgaon. And the other division comprised of Mahim, Parel, Sion and Worli. Judicial administration or the court which were established at Bombay, a separate court of judicature was established for each division at Bombay and Mahim. Because the Bombay was divided into two divisions. So, one division was Bombay and the other was Mahim. The composition of the court consisted of 5 judges. The court were to be presided over by the customs officers. And the custom officers were Englishmen. Some of the judges were Indians also because it was not possible for an Englishman to have adequate knowledge of Indian laws, and therefore some Indians or some judges were Indians. Some Indians were also appointed to assist him in the court of judicature in each division. The quorum of the court was 3 judges. Jurisdiction of the court of judicature. This court authorized or empowered to hear and try and determine petty cases, both civil and criminal. cases of small thefts and all civil actions up to 200 zerapins. Zerapins was Portuguese coin, and 20 zerapins were equal to nearly rupees 150. Appeal from this court of judicature. An appeal from the court of each division was allowed to the court of deputy governor and council at Bombay. In other words, the provisions were made for the establishment of a superior court of the deputy governor and the council. The court exercised both original and appellate jurisdiction. The court decided cases with the help of the jury. Further, appeal from deputy governor and council was allowed to president and council at Surat in rare cases. Drawbacks or demerits of administration of justice at Bombay during the first period. The judicial system of 1670 have following demerits or drawbacks. The first one is the judges of both the courts, that is lower court, and the lower court was court of judicature, and the upper court was the court of deputy governor and council, had no knowledge of law. There were no trained lawyers appointed as judges in the both the courts. They were merely traders, and they were not having elementary knowledge of law or the basic knowledge of law because they were basically traders. Second, the executive and judicial powers were not separate. The executive and judicial powers were exercised by the same persons. And as a consequence, the abuse of power, because there was concentration of power, and as a consequences of this, the abuse of power created various new problems in the judicial system. In order to remove defects, Ongier, he was a governor of Bombay, requested the company's authorities to provide persons who were expert in law. So after some time, Ongier selected George Wilcox, who was expert in law, with whose advice he prepared a new plan in 1672 for the administration of justice in Bombay. So to remedy these defects, new judicial system was enforced in 1672. So let's discuss new judicial plan of 1672. According to new plan, all cases were to be tried according to English law and not according to Portuguese law, because earlier Portuguese laws were applied. So English law introduced into Bombay. Second, new plan provided for the establishment of central court at Bombay, to be presided over by a single judge to try all civil, criminal and testamentary cases. Testamentary means probate of will or relating to will. So George Wilcox was the first lawyer appointed as the judge of the court. The court sat once a week to try civil cases with the help of jury. Third provision was made, court fees could be charged. Fee of 5% of valuation of the suit from the litigants were charged. Number fourth provision was for administering criminal justice. Bombay was divided into four divisions, namely Bombay, Mahim, Mazgaon and Sion. In each division, court was headed by Justice of Peace, and Justice of Peace was an Englishman. He acted as committing magistrate to arrest the accused and examine the witnesses, and after recording the necessary proceedings, the record was then placed before the court of judicature. He sent the accused to the central court for trial. And the central court was court of judicature. The central court for trial where the accused was to be tried with the help of jury. The justice of peace also acted as assessors to help the central court, that is to help the court of judicature in disposing of the cases. The provision was made for appeal to the court of deputy governor and council after the decision of justice of peace. Number six, the provision was made for the establishment of a court of conscience to decide petty civil cases up to 20 zerapins. It meet once a week and cases were disposed of summarily. No court fee was charged from poor persons. The court became famous as poor man's court. So during this period, the considerable development occurred or have taken place. First one is the Portuguese law came to be replaced by the English law. And the second development was in trial court, lawyers were appointed as judges. Thus, there was a good beginning of administration of justice at Bombay. And this system continued till 1683. So with this, I have completed administration of justice during first stage. Thank you.